Connection, belonging, and intimacy are some of our most important needs. And to fulfill those needs, many people decide to join intentional communities.
And that includes us also.
Unfortunately though, sometimes it's not exactly as we envisioned it. We might end up being completely disillusioned and not get those needs met. And just end up feeling hurt and not understanding why it's so difficult. Guys, we really wish that someone told us about these challenges. And that's why we want to share with you in this video the 6 biggest challenges that we have faced in the past 3 years living in intentional communities. And at the end, we're also gonna give you a summary of exactly how you can overcome those challenges. So stick with us.
So the first challenge is triggers, and this something can arise if you're living with your partner or living with the community, with your parents, everywhere.
Like just living with people, like you're bound to get triggered at some point.
Yeah, exactly.
You can't avoid it. It's just in a community you have more opportunities for self-awareness.
When you get triggered, usually if you're not aware of your trigger, you might try to project your pain on others. He said something wrong. She doesn't treat me fairly.
And that can create a lot of conflicts
in
the community. And so really the key here is to, when the trigger arises, meaning we feel upset, angry, sad, desperate, that we are able to look within and do the necessary inner work to understand why we're feeling this way. And we will notice, we will find that those triggers have their roots in the past. Like half of the anger we feel doesn't even belong to the present moment.
Yeah. So every time you get triggered, just sit with yourself and feel like, why am I actually triggered? What's underneath this?
Yeah, it's super important to not brush those feelings under the carpet, because it's just gonna accumulate. And at some point, the trigger is gonna get so big that it's gonna explode into a massive conflict. Or if you don't wanna face the conflict, you might decide to leave.
Yeah, exactly. And this is one reason why 90% of intentional community failed. The second challenge is conflicting needs. We're gonna give you an example how this conflict might arise from our previous community in Berlin. We had one of the community members, she started to be aware of her need of safety. We noticed that we have this conflicting needs that she wants to close up and have a containment in the group. We had the need to open up for new people and have like people coming.
More input, like expansion, you know.
Expansion,
from people.
Openness.
And the issue is not usually even the conflicting needs itself, because oftentimes we are trying to meet our needs with a specific strategy.
Yeah.
And it's very possible to come up with an alternative solution most of the time. The key is really to become aware of your needs, and everybody in the community should be aware of what their needs are.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
Then you can talk about solutions that meet everybody's needs. What happens when somebody in the group is not aware of their needs? The thing is, the need doesn't go away. If the need goes unmet, they're gonna start finding ways to get their needs met.
Indirectly,
and sometimes in a manipulative way, unconsciously. So for example, if someone has a big need to be appreciated, but they are either might be ashamed of asking for or bringing that up, or not even aware of it, it might start coming up in a way where they expect to receive appreciation from others in the form of money or favors or or just words. And then when they don't get it, they start feeling resentful
and acting passive aggressive.
So know your needs.
Very important.
Before you get into a community or even before you live with anybody, really.
And that leads us to the challenge number 3, which is unspoken expectation. You might be upset that somebody didn't clean up the dish after they finish eating.
And you might think it's obvious. Obviously they should know to clean up. However, that's actually an unspoken expectation.
Exactly.
People might have different, you know, standards for cleanliness. And it might just be a matter of expressing those expectations.
And it could be something even bigger, like for example, people might expect if they join community, they would suddenly be included and everybody would love them and hug them and welcome them, which can happen a lot in communities. But it's also unspoken expectation. So work those expectations out before joining people, before living with the community, because it's so important to know what to expect.
How we notice that we have also unspoken expectations that maybe we haven't voiced is when we feel upset with something.
Yeah.
And the upsetness is often a signal that we expected something else than what we got.
That's true.
And that's a very important moment to look inside and notice, what was it that I was expecting? Can I communicate to the people, hey guys, when I joined this community, I realize now mm-hmm. that I was expecting to connect with you guys on a daily basis. I wonder if this is a need that could be met. I wonder if it's unreasonable to expect this. And maybe mm-hmm. the other people will say, actually, I have the same expectation, but I was ashamed to say it. You
yeah,
know?
So. Or it could be that actually I'm fulfilled with my needs right now and I just want to connect when I feel like doing that, which is like every second day or third day. And then you're clear that this is not a community for you and mm-hmm. you can look for something that suits your needs. The challenge number four, imbalance in sharing the resources. And what we say resources is not only financial resource or physical resource, but also emotional resource, which is the fundamental base of a community.
Mm-hmm. So this might come up in, for example, in the resource of energy put into common mm-hmm. projects. Mm-hmm. Or if, let's say, somebody needs a lot of emotional support.
Mm-hmm. But not able to give it back mm-hmm. for a long period of time.
So this can create like a draining point for the mm-hmm. community, that instead of supporting the community, is almost like pulling it down, is dragging mm-hmm. the energy down.
So it's very important to create balance from the moment of choosing whom to join the community, to have like an overview, like we'd be able to support each other if we go like in an emotional heartbreak, if we have like enough resources to invest in the project that we do.
Yeah, exactly. Do we have enough financial resources? Mm-hmm. Do we have enough energy, physical energy to carry yeah. out projects? And do we have enough emotional resources to caretake everybody in the community? Point number five is enmeshment. Mm-hmm. This is not having clear personal boundaries, which causes us to do things that we actually deep inside don't want to do. Mm-hmm. It causes us to overextend ourselves, to self-sacrifice, and to basically agree to things that are not in alignment with yeah. our personal truths. Paradoxically, we need to first become individuals before we can successfully live with other people. So enmeshment is kind of like not having access to our own personal truth, our mm-hmm. boundaries, yeah. our likes and preferences, and yeah. then instead kind of like blending in with other people mm-hmm. and simply accepting whatever is their boundary, whatever is their preference.
Yeah, and that would lead in long term for resentment. Like you would feel like, I can't like be myself, like I have to adopt. But actually it's something that you chose to do.
Yes, it's very self-abandonment.
Yeah, it's very important to become aware of what's your needs in this setting, in this community, yes. in this place that you live in, so you can communicate it to others.
And believe it or not, when you have clarity about your own identity, who you are, this creates a very safe environment for other people to interact mm-hmm. with you, because they feel like they can trust what you say. They feel like when you have a boundary, they can trust that boundary and it's not gonna be like shifting all the time. What happens often with enmeshment is that our boundaries keep shifting, and this is very confusing for other people.
And we will share with you how you can resolve those challenges. But let's first talk about the last point.
Number six.
The last one that can actually break community apart is incompatibility.
So this could be, for example, that the members of the community have completely different values that mm-hmm. don't go together, or a different vision for what the community should look like.
It could be some people want it to be like a child safe community and other people just want to have it like open for party, for festivals.
It's very important to have a set of shared values between the community members and have those visible for people who potentially want to join the community. So a value that we have in our community, for example, mm-hmm. would be non-harm, and this translates to veganism in the way we eat. We have a big value for emotional closeness. So if somebody comes who is totally unable to be present and is unwilling to develop those capacities, that would be an incompatibility. It's super important that the community builds this vision and set of values mm-hmm. in a very early stage.
So we'll summarize the most important things that you have to deal as fast as possible, either if you're living in a community or you want to live in a community.
First of all, become aware of your own needs and mm-hmm. expectations.
Yeah.
What is it that you need the most at this point in your life, and what would you wish to receive from the community? How do you wish that the community fulfills those needs?
Yeah.
So that's your needs and expectations.
And then come the awareness of your own trigger, like whenever you're triggered, it's so important to reflect on it and share it with others so they can understand you more and connect with you more and understand why you're upset. That leads us to the next point, which is communication. So learn how to communicate clearly. Maybe you can use nonviolent communication or other modality where you can, circling, for example, you can express authentically what's happening in you.
So authentic, direct, and immediate communication. Yeah. Don't let things build up. Express as soon as possible and as directly, without going in roundabout ways, express what's inside of you, what your needs. This is my needs, this is my expectation, and this is what I feel.
And by the way, living in a community, it might have like a downside we just talk about a lot of today, but it has amazing benefits. And we made a video about it, why we choose to live in a community, so check it out next. And subscribe to see more videos about community living.
Thank you so much for watching, guys, and leave a comment below if you have anything to ask.
And we will answer all the comments, and also let us know if you have lived in a community, what was your experience. If you missed something in this video, we would love to read it all and answer it and enrich our experience and connect with you.
All right, bye for now.
Love you guys.